Greetings again everyone, my name is Chris and today I'll be testing out a brand new super telephoto zoom lens from Sigma, the 150-600mm f/5-6.3 DG/DN/OS Sports. It'll be hitting the market later this month and will be priced at £1,200 in the UK, or I imagine about $1,300 US. For a premium quality lens of this kind, which it is marketed as being, that could be a fairly reasonable price. I'd like to thank Sigma UK for loaning me this lens for a couple of weeks for testing, although as usual, this is a totally independent review. This thing is for L-mount mirrorless cameras or Sony E-mount mirrorless cameras, full frame or APS-C, and its zoom range of 150-600mm is long telephoto all the way. 600mm is an absolutely awesome reach, really. This lens's maximum aperture of f5 at the wide angle end to 6.3 when zoomed in is hardly bright, it's a little bit dark actually, but it does keep the lens's size and price down, and it can still get you some nicely out of focus backgrounds in your shot if that's what you're looking for. The lens features its own image stabilization system too, which I will turn on here. It doesn't seem terribly effective for video work, to be honest, but in my tests, I found that it seemed to work much better when getting still pictures, maybe about 3 or 4 stops of assistance. Another feature of the lens is that, when zoomed out to 150mm, it has a fantastically close minimum focus distance, getting you very close indeed to smaller subjects. Well, let's start by looking at its build quality. A few years ago, Sigma launched 2 versions of this lens for digital SLR cameras, a smaller, lighter version called the Contemporary version, and a bigger, heavier one called the Sports version. This new Sports version of the lens for mirrorless cameras is around the same size and weight as the older Contemporary version, but far smaller and lighter than the old Sports version, while keeping that version's features and robust build quality. It's made of a mixture of aluminium and Sigma's thermally stable composite, basically a very heavy duty plastic, and the lens weighs just over 2 kg, or about 4.5 pounds. The lens's mount is made of metal, unsurprisingly, and has a weather sealing gasket. Sigma advertised the lens as being generally dust and splash resistant. It's also compatible with Sigma's teleconverters, which are currently only available for L-mount cameras, not Sony E-mount cameras. Then you get a number of switches for controlling and customizing the focus and image stabilization settings. If you use the Sigma USB dock, then you'll be able to customize how they work a bit more precisely. Then comes a strong metallic tripod collar. It can be turned and controlled quite neatly and easily, although it will be difficult to remove it altogether. In front of that comes a rubberized focus ring, which turns very smoothly and responds very well with the focus motor. Here you can see that the lens displays almost no focus breathing, keeping its focal length no matter where you're focused. Here's the autofocus motor at work. On my Sony a7R III, it worked fairly quickly and quietly, and it seemed to be quite accurate too, so that's great. The lens's zoom ring is large and rubberized and turns quite evenly. You can set it to turn reasonably smoothly or more tightly, or you can lock it into position at 150mm. The lens comes with a carrying strap, a nice large padded bag, and a lens hood which has a fabric cover that can also be used as a lens cap, like on really big expensive Canon L telephoto zoom lenses, as well as a normal 95mm lens cap. The very front of the lens is edged in rubber in order to protect it from knocks and bumps. Overall, while it is a little big and heavy, unsurprisingly for a zoom lens ending in 600mm, its build quality overall is nice and solid, and everything about it works very well. Video makers may be a little dissatisfied with its image stabilization, though. Well, let's take a look at image quality now. We will start by testing it on a full frame camera, my 42MP Sony a7R III. In-camera corrections are turned on here. At the widest angle of 150mm and f5, the lens is very sharp in the middle, with quite good contrast. Over in the corners, there's only a tiny reduction in image quality, which is great to see. Stop down to f8 and those corners are a tiny bit sharper and brighter, and back in the middle, contrast and resolution now look excellent. The lens stays this sharp down to about f16, where the effects of diffraction are softening the image a little. Let's zoom in about halfway now to 350mm. At f5.6, again, the middle of the image isn't quite razor sharp, but it is pretty good, and contrast is just good here. The corners look a little softer here, but not too bad. Again, stop down to f8 and they sharpen up nicely, and image quality back in the middle becomes excellent again. f11 looks about the same. Let's zoom in all the way to 600mm now, where the maximum aperture has darkened to f6.3. The good news is that the middle of the image remains nice and sharp here, even at the maximum aperture, and contrast is looking very good. On contrasting edges, however, you can observe a little colour fringing, just a touch. The further good news is that the corners are virtually as sharp here. Stop down to f8 and those corners look excellent, and back in the middle, that colour fringing has gone. Again, the lens stays this sharp down to f16. So, overall, on a full frame camera, this Sigma lens is displaying very good sharpness very consistently from the middle of the image into the corners across the whole zoom range. So, you can't really ask much more than that out of a mid-range super zoom lens. I was particularly pleased with its sharpness at 600mm, although it's very slightly less sharp in the middle of its zoom range. Now, let's give the lens a slightly different challenge by testing it on an APS-C camera, my little 24MP Sony A5100. At 150mm straight from f5, we see excellent sharpness and contrast here in the middle of the image, and over into the corners too. Again, the lens stays this sharp down to f16. Zooming into 350mm, the lens is just a little less sharp now in the middle, and the corners look a little softer now at f5.6. The lens stays about as sharp down to f11 from the corner and back into the middle. Let's zoom all the way into 600mm now. Here at f6.3, the lens is just decently sharp and contrast is just good. The corner image quality is about the same, but a little darker. Stop down to f8 and those corners brighten up a little, and the middle of the image sees some very good sharpness and contrast now. Again, the lens stays this sharp down to f16. Overall, well, super telephoto zoom lenses often really struggle on APS-C cameras, but this new Sigma Sports lens is just about sharp enough to give some dependable results. Its weakest point is at 600mm and f6.3, but even then, just stop down to f8 and the lens sharpens up again nicely, so there's not much to realistically complain about here. Alright, let's see about distortion and vignetting on a full frame camera. These pictures are taken with in-camera corrections turned off. Throughout the entire zoom range, the lens exhibits some moderate pincushion distortion. At the widest angle of f5, there is some noticeable darkness in the corners, but stop down to f8 or f11 to see that go away. Zoom into 600mm and at f6.3, the corners are fairly dark now, although again, stop down to f8 or better yet f11 and those corners will greatly brighten up. So, it's a completely average performance here for distortion and vignetting for this kind of lens. Let's take a look at close-up image quality now. If you want the closest possible pictures, then zoom the lens out to 150mm. Here, you can focus as closely as 58cm, which is pretty astonishing. At f5, that close-up image quality is a little softer, but still quite usable. Stop down to f8 or f11 for some excellent sharpness. Now, let's see how the lens copes against bright lights. It is a fairly good performance. Whether you're zoomed in or out, your contrast remains fairly good, although flaring artifacts will be visible too when bright lights are directly in the picture. And finally, bokeh. Despite the lens's slightly dark maximum aperture, it's still pretty easy to get out-of-focus backgrounds here on such telephoto focal lengths. Those out-of-focus backgrounds virtually always looked beautiful and smooth to me, very soft indeed, although if you have a very difficult background, you can provoke a little edginess out of it. Overall, while the Sigma 150-600mm DGDN sports lens is hardly revolutionary, it certainly has a few nice little improvements over its much older brothers for digital SLR cameras. Its autofocus is a little better, a little more efficient, its build quality a little more robust, and more importantly, its image quality is slightly sharper too. And the older 150 to 600mm lenses were not soft lenses, so everything's come up roses with this one. It competes with a new Tamron lens that's also just been released for Sony E-mount cameras, the Tamron 150-500mm f5-6.7. The Tamron lens has a slightly different philosophy behind it, being designed to be as small and light as possible for such an extreme telephoto optic, and it certainly is more compact and a little lighter than the Sigma lens. Other than that, they both have very similar build quality, image stabilization, and autofocus speed, but in my tests, I found the Sigma lens to be a little sharper than the Tamron. It also reaches to 600mm instead of 500, and the Sigma lens has a slightly brighter maximum aperture and a lower price as well. So in most cases, I'd recommend the Sigma lens over the Tamron unless you need your lens to be as small as possible, which is admittedly advantageous for going travelling. Ultimately though, this Sigma 150-600mm DGDN sports lens is a nice little upgrade over their older 150-600mm lenses, which were already pretty good, so it's a brilliant option for all kinds of telephoto work, which comes highly recommended. You know what else is highly recommended? Checking out my Patreon page, of course. Duh. Over there, supporters of this channel get all kinds of exclusive content every week, including special monthly videos and sneak previews of upcoming reviews. Check it out in the description below. Take care and God bless.